Do's and don'ts with Dave, parent edition. Number one, pump your player up. Make sure that they're confident. Make sure they feel confident by telling them what they really did well in the last game, what they did well at practice. If they do a lot of work on their own, remind them of that. Plant the seeds for that strong psychological mindset. Number two, doesn't matter if it's a cup final, state cup final, scrimmage, regular game. Do not add to the manicness of the day by acting crazy. So the players are looking at you to be a nice, calming, relaxing influence. So on the car or in the car on the way to the game, just be tranquil, be relaxing. You can talk about the day, but don't try to get hold of your own anxiety and not give it to them. And again, doesn't matter how big the game is. Number three, super, super important. Let them know before the game, no matter what the result is, let that child know how important they are to you. Number four, super, super important. Do not give your player instructions on how to play that game, because pretty much guaranteed your instructions are going to contradict the coach's instructions. And I always say to parents, how would you like it if the coach came into your job? So if you're a lawyer, the coach comes in and starts telling you how to do your job, even though you don't want to do it like that. It's the same thing, so let the coach coach. Number five, and this is massive, don't talk smack on your kid's coach or other team members, because eventually that kind of toxicity is going to bleed into your player, and your player is going to join the blame culture, and they're never ever going to really realize their own potential because it is toxic. So even if you feel that way about the coach, not in front of your kids, and especially not about other players, because that's just going to form a toxic environment. Number six, remember to remind your player why they play football, soccer, and remind them that the whole reason we're playing is way more than just soccer. It's life lessons, it's social lessons, and it's lessons on how to succeed. Okay, so now you're at the game. So tip number seven is how to act during that game. So what you want to do on the sidelines is just be a really good fan and relax, respect everyone around you. You know, the amount of times that I've seen fully grown adults going crazy, like teenagers, it's insane. So you've got to respect the ref, you've got to respect the other coaches and obviously the other players, and respect the other parents. Like a lot of parents get to the game and they open their car door and they get out and they close the door, but they leave something very, very important inside the car, and that's their common sense. Tip number eight. Now, if you want to know if you are a crazy soccer parent, because most do not know, they don't realize it, here is a tip for you. Just get an iPhone and a tripod or a camera. Just set it up so it captures all the parents and then forget about it. At the end, just watch that sideline of parents and you'll soon be able to see who was acting crazy. The results may surprise you. Hopefully, you're an angel of a parent.